Take care of all those charms, and you'll always be in someone's arms. Keep young and beautiful if you want to be loved.
The current emphasis on excessive thinness for women is one of the clearest examples of advertising's power to influence us, both culturally and individually. Now, I'm certainly not saying today that advertising is solely to blame for all of this. These stereotypes exist in every aspect of our lives, but there's no aspect more pervasive or more persuasive than advertising. Research indicates that the self-esteem of girls in America plummets when they reach adolescence. This doesn't happen to boys, but it does to girls. Girls tend to feel fine about themselves when they're 8, 9, 10 years old, but they reach adolescence and they hit a wall. And at least part of that wall seems to be this relentless emphasis on physical perfection that starts so early for girls. 1 in 10 young women in America today has a serious eating disorder, the most common of which are anorexia and bulimia. If you define an eating disorder more broadly to include being obsessed with food or terribly worried about your weight, probably 9 out of 10 would be a fairer estimate. And it seems to be starting earlier and earlier all the time. A recent survey of fourth grade girls found that 80% of them were on diets, which means they're doing horrible, probably irreversible damage to their bodies, their bones, their metabolisms, to say nothing of their psyches and their spirits. Where else could this come from, this crazy obsession with excessive thinness for women, except at least in part from the media images that surround us and that tell us in order to be acceptable, we need to be painfully, unnaturally thin. Yesterday's sex symbols by today's standards would be considered fat. This, of course, is Marilyn Monroe. Look at her, she's got a tummy, she's got hips. Compare Marilyn Monroe with Kate Moss. It's a completely different body type, completely different. And in fact, 20 years ago, the average model weighed 8% less than the average woman. Today, she weighs 23% less. Women's bodies haven't changed. What's changed is the ideal. And a body type that statistically 5% of American women have, and you are either born with this body type or not. You cannot diet yourself into it any more than you can make yourself taller. And it's a body type that statistically excludes about 95% of American women, but it's the only one we ever see in the media as acceptable or desirable. This is an ad from Advertising Age, which is the major publication of the advertising industry. What's going on here? The Ladies Home Journal is advertising itself directly to the executives of Coca-Cola as a terrific place to put their Diet Coke ads. What's being sold here isn't Diet Coke, or even really the Ladies Home Journal. What's being sold are the readers of the Ladies Home Journal, who are made to feel anxious about their weight, and they are being sold to the diet industry. If their primary purpose is to get the ads, and that's undeniable, they're not likely to give us information that's going to make the ads look bad. The last diet you'll ever need, and then a plate full of cookies, and then on the back cover, a cigarette ad. Now, what does that have to do with anything? Quite a bit, because the obsession with thinness is used not only to sell diet products, it's used to sell the deadliest product of all, cigarettes. And it's used again and again. Misty, slim and sassy. Capri, sleek. Newport, slim lights. You won't find a cigarette ad targeting girls or women that doesn't use the word slim, slender, sleek. If I ran the world, calories wouldn't count. But of course they do count, and here she's able to resist the food because she's got a cigarette. So this ad is clearly telling young women that they should smoke instead of eat, that this is a way to avoid gaining weight. The tobacco industry has to get 3,000 children to start smoking every single day simply to replace those smokers who die or quit. They're in the business of getting children addicted to nicotine. 90% of all smokers start before they're 18, 60% start before high school. So they're targeting girls, girls, little girls often, with ads like this, suggesting that they smoke since, of course, they're not allowed to eat. We must challenge these images. Advertisers will never voluntarily change because the truth is it is profitable for them for women to feel terrible about themselves. It is profitable for the advertisers.